and then you pay off your credit cards again. And then what do you do after that? Do you run them back up again or do you leave them low? So they're going to be looking at you that way. So what's been said is that around 40 million people are going to benefit from this FICO 10, and your credit scores may go up about 20 points. At the same time, about 40 million people, and they're going to look at your credit and how you've utilized it over the last 24 months, how you've utilized your credit over the last 24 months, and then you may lose 20 points or so. Now, from my experience thus far, and it's only been, you know, a couple of months, my experience thus far is that I have yet to find people that I think it went up because of, that their credit scores went up because of FICO 10. Their credit scores went up because of different activities, different strategies, different actions that they've taken that are positive for their credit. However, some individuals, now your credit scores always fluctuated, but some individuals' credit scores have seemed to gone down when they've done some borrowing or they've placed some more or they use their credit cards a little more than they normally do. And their scores have gone down. And more than these 20 points that they point out in when you're talking about FICO to FICO people, right? So it's been more than 20 points, more like 25, 30 points that their credit scores have gone down by not making huge purchases or buying, you know, $5,000 worth of furniture. I'm talking about putting like $300 on a credit card that you never use, that this has happened. So it's going to help as many people as it's going to hurt, like I said earlier. So 40 million people are probably going to get a boost of about 20 points. 40 million people are probably going to go down about 20 points. All right. So this is what's happening. Here's what they're doing. So they're taking a look at your credit card debt, and this is what they're looking for. So before, like you can see, and they could see it as well because they didn't necessarily track what your balances were, but they would just take that snapshot. This is the day we're looking at Kevin King's credit. If it's the 15th of the month, it's the 15th of the month or whatever. And here's what his balances are. And they just, you know, make a note of it, or, you know, it's on your credit report. Now they're going back, they're looking 24 months, and they're trying to track what have you done in the last 24 months with your credit. So did you run up a bunch of credit on your, a bunch of debt on your credit cards? And then have you paid it down slowly over time? Or are you just making those payments every month and it's pretty much the same balance or whatever because of interest and whatnot? Or did you go and take out a personal loan, pay off of all those credit card debts, and now what's happening with your credit cards? So that's what they're looking at right now. They're going back 24 months. They're trying to evaluate what's the risk with this person about how are they going to pay in the future. So that's what they're trying to evaluate. So they're going to look and see what you're doing. So that means if you happen to go out and you buy something on your credit card, and then you just make the minimum payments. You're making the minimum payments every month. It appears that this FICO 10 is going to hurt your credit score slightly. It's going to hurt your credit score if you're doing that. You're going to pay just the minimums on your balances every month. It appears that this FICO 10 is going to hurt your credit score. Now, if you are the person that you know, if you go out and, like I mentioned, $300, you put $300 on it, the next month you pay, you know, $100, and the next month you pay it another $100, and the next month, you know, you were done with that $300 you added to that credit report, to that credit card, then it's not going to help you. It's just not going to hurt you for doing it that way. All right. Now, let's take this scenario, and they keep bringing up every time I watch something, listen to something, talk to someone, they keep bringing up about personal loans and debt consolidations and consolidating your credit cards. For a long time, I've been giving the strategy to people to do a debt consolidation often to help them with their credit scores. One client credit score went up 65 points after he did a consolidation on his credit cards and did a personal loan. It went up. Now, he kept those credit card balances low or at a zero, so that absolutely helped them out. So here's what they're looking at now. A lot of personal loans have been happening. And part of that result is simply because credit scores are going up, so more people are eligible to get a personal loan. So since people are eligible to get a personal loan, they've been doing so, and they've been paying off credit cards with that, not only just getting a personal loan so they can go on vacation or, you know, buy them a motorcycle or whatever it is. They've been getting these personal loans, and they've been paying off their credit card debt with it. So now, if you go ahead and get that personal loan, that's going to consolidate your credit card debt. They're watching that credit card debt to see if you spend money on that credit card. So if you spend money on those credit cards that you use for the that you got the personal loan for, that's going to hurt your credit score. Now, how much? I don't know. I don't know at this point. There's not enough data. There hasn't been enough time to say how many points is that going to hurt your credit score. But if you're doing a debt consolidation at this point, if you pay off your credit cards, I'm going to suggest that you not go right back out and you charge them up. I would have suggested that before anyway, because that's probably one of the issues that may have something that had been an issue for you. You know, all those payments that you had to make, even if you made those payments, just the amount of money that you were paying on those credit cards versus a personal loan that has a term, which means it ends at some point. Those credit cards, they don't necessarily end if you just keep making the monthly payment on them. They don't necessarily end. And when they do, it's 13 years out. It's 14 years out. It's 15 years out before you pay off that debt and you've paid a whole bunch of interest on it. So there's absolutely nothing wrong with getting a personal loan and consolidating that. You just cannot, especially in these times and with FICO 10, go back out and use those credit cards again and run them up. You cannot do that. That is going to hurt your credit. So if you did it for money's sake, because it's going to save you money on a monthly basis, and you know when this particular personal loan is over in 3 years, in 4 years, in 5 years, I'm going to be out of debt, not a bad thing. Not a bad thing at all. Not a bad thing for your pocketbook, and not a bad thing necessarily for your credit score if you don't go back and charge those credit cards up. Too often, that's what people do. We go back out and we use those credit cards. And we start simply, we say, we're not going to do it. We're not, I am not going to use this credit card. We say it, I'm not going to use it anymore or whatever. And then you might use it just once, you know, for, you know, just for a little something. You're like, oh man, I'm going to just use the credit card right quick. And then it gets easier and easier. And you look back up, and that debt's back there again. So that's one of the things that you cannot do on FICO 10. It's definitely going to hurt your credit score if you do that. Now, who is it going to help? So if you, it's like I said, it's going to help as many people as it's going to hurt. So if you just, like, if you at you know, Christmas time, a holiday or whatever, or it's vacation time, and you use your credit card, you run it up during those times or whatever, if you go ahead and, you know, make those payments, because that's considered like a one-time spike. Like, you did it just one time, you ran it up, and then you start making those payments on it, making more than the minimum. So it's going to hurt people that only make the minimum on their credit cards. But if you had that spike, and then, like I said, if it was $300, you paid $100 the next month and $100 the next month, and basically it was almost gone, it's not going to hurt you as much with that if you had that one-time spike. Now, you've got to trust the system. The system has to know what's going on and actually be able to see it. I don't know if the system can do that, but hopefully it is. So hopefully, like, the people that, you know, charge things and pay the whole credit card off every month, hopefully this doesn't bother you at all. But it could. There's just not enough time to say what's what at this particular point in time. Because if you use, you gotta, you know, you pay all your bills on a credit card because you're getting the rewards points and stuff. And you're getting all those reward points, and you pay it, and then you pay it off every month at the end of the month. This may be helpful for you, or it may hurt you, because they might look back at that 24 months and say, man, this person got, you know, $5,000 balance, and every month, you know, they're spending $4,000 every month, and most months they pay the whole thing off. Sometimes there's a lingering balance on there. You may have paid it off, you may not. You may have been caught between when they report it versus when you pay. So they're going to look at that and say, man, this person is risky because look how much they use their credit cards. Potentially that will happen. So I don't know just yet. I need probably another good 4 months 4 or 5 months looking at data and seeing what happens with FICO 10 to kind of see how it's going to really impact you. So here's what you need to do at the end of the day. Here's what you need to do. You need to stay the course. Stay the course at the end of the day. Get 5 pillars of credit. Know those 5 pillars. Stay within those things at the end of the day. That's going to keep your credit score nice and quote unquote steady, if you will, if you follow those principles, if you will. If you follow those 5 pillars, then you're going to be perfectly fine. You'll be perfectly fine. So don't panic over FICO 10. Like I said, not every place is going to get FICO 10. If you're buying a home, they're probably going to have FICO 10. If you're refinancing, they're probably going to be using FICO 10 because they get the latest and the greatest, right? So those things that happen. But if you just stay the course with what you've been doing, you've been listening to the 800 Credit Score Man show, you caught up on all the things, you contacted me, you emailed me, at 800@creditscoreman.com, or you called me, at 312-600-5855, and we talked about a particular situation for you, then stay the course. Simply stay the course and you'll be perfectly fine. You want to keep your credit card utilization under 30%. There's ways to do that, right? So if you're over 30% right now, but your credit score is good, you know, you're at or above average, or maybe even a little bit below average, nothing wrong with getting a little increase. If you get an increase on your credit limits and you don't spend it, that brings down your credit utilization. So you can get closer to that 30%, or you can even be below that 30%. You see those things happening on your credit reports, and you're going to be perfectly fine. You see those things happening on your credit score. So that's about it. What we're talking about with FICO 10 today. I hope that was clear as mud. For you guys when it comes to the FICO 10 that's coming out. You got questions, don't hesitate to contact me. You need to, you can follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, 800 Credit Score Man, on both of those entities. On Twitter, I'm at @CreditScore_Man on Twitter. I always follow you back on Twitter. So if you need a follower on Twitter, then hit me up and I will follow you back on Twitter for sure. All right, so you guys do that. Don't forget, go to figures.com. You got some wireless issues, you want to save some money on your monthly plan or what have you, like I said, you can get 4 lines for $120. Unlimited text, unlimited this, unlimited that. If you're an international player, you're everywhere. Well, you might not be going anywhere right now for the coronavirus. They even have an international plan that is not that much money. So you guys go check out Figures and use my code. Use my code credit score at Figures so you can get 25% off as well. And go out and get the book. Go out and get the ebook, 5 Pillars of Credit, and that'll help you. You got questions, again, call me, contact me so I can answer those questions for you directly. I've missed you guys so much. I've missed being on air. I'm glad to be back. The new studio was cool. The equipment's cool. You know, everything takes a little bit of getting used to. So the new equipment is cool, and we'll be back next week. If you have a show topic that you want to talk about, please contact me. Send me what your show topic is, because we've done so many shows and we've talked about a lot of stuff. But if you got something specific that you want to talk about, then you send that to me. Yes, shout outs will be back again. They'll be back again. Just way too many shout outs to them. But I'm going to shout out at the end of this show one person in particular. So I need to shout out my sister. My sister's birthday is on Valentine's Day, and this year, my sister turned the big 6-0. I know, you'd be like, man, this dude cannot have a sister that's 60 years old. Don't worry, she's my big, big sister. She's got me by over a decade. I'm not that old. So, happy birthday to you, Pam Poo. Happy birthday to you. And you know how I got to do before I get out of here, y'all. Kobe, Cameron, and Carter, I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. I'm out.